In our last video, we did a teardown on iPhone 14. Today we will show you how to separate and combine the motherboard of iPhone 14. Furthermore, to share motherboard differences and repair difficulties. The iPhone 14 changes to the glass sandwich design. Opens from the back end, we can see the motherboard move to right side of battery. The iPhone 14 still features an L-shaped motherboard, as iPhone 13. Different from iPhone 13, the iPhone 14 has components on four sides of the motherboard. Spreading out the components will result in better heat dissipation. The two main components, the NAND and PMU, have moved to the back of motherboard. In order to remove foam completely, we used PCB cleaner to make it wet. The A15 Bionic logo attached on baseband RF transceiver, instead of not. Add heat around the motherboard with hot air gun at 100 degrees Celsius. Remove the heat dissipation tapes. Remove the tape. There is a reserved part for 5G millimeter wave patch antenna. We continue to remove tapes on the back of the motherboard. There is still time for the iPhone 14 specialized heating platform to reach the market. We used iPhone 12 heating platform for motherboard separation. Put the motherboard on the 150 degrees Celsius heating platform to heat. Because the middle layer of iPhone 14 lineup's motherboard still uses middle temperature solder paste for soldering, therefore, we still need to add heat with hot air gun. Add heat with hot air gun at 360 degrees Celsius. Use the metal knife along the edge of the motherboard until it becomes loose. Compared with the predecessor, the layout of motherboard has switched position. Upper layer becomes the signal board, and the lower layer is the logic board. Remove thermal grease on the chips. The iPhone 14's baseband CPU has been upgraded to the Qualcomm X65. It is believed that the phone signal will be more stable than previous models. As the CPU distributes at the lower layer of middle frame, operating space is reduced by the tiny gap between CPU and frame, which makes CPU desoldering more difficult. For better look at the layout of components, remove the shield and cover. Use hot air gun at 380 degrees Celsius, take out the shield and cover. The upper signal board applies both radio and intermediate frequency ICs, which makes stronger signal. There is no stuff for millimeter wave part. Clean the glue attached with shield and cover. Please do not damage surrounding components while removing. Clean the bonding pads with soldering iron at 380 degrees Celsius and solder wick. Please do not affect surrounding components while applying solder paste. This should also be noted while using soldering iron to remove tin. Clean the bonding pads with PCB cleaner. Use hot air gun at 380 degrees Celsius to solder the shielding cover on motherboard. Due to the oversize of PMU, add heat with solder iron for better soldering. Then we reball the logic board. Put the reballing stencil in position. Apply low temperature solder paste evenly. Heat the logic board by turning on the heating platform at 180 degrees Celsius. After the solder balls are formed, turn off the heating platform and cool down the logic board. Detach the reballing stencil. Turn on the heating platform. Apply some paste flux to the bonding pads. Align the logic board with the signal board to combine motherboard completely. Turn off heating platform. After the motherboard has cooled, detach the motherboard. Reattach foam and heat dissipation tapes to the motherboard. Install the motherboard for testing. The phone turns on normally. In summary, the motherboard is big changes in appearance compared with iPhone 13. and it is found that iPhone 14 still has a double-layered motherboard with components on four sides which facilitates heat dissipation. But the redesign of logic board and signal board, which makes more difficulties for CPU soldering and desoldering. Besides, the iPhone 14 uses Qualcomm X65 and radio and intermediate frequency design to improve phone signal. Thanks to Wire Repair who share the IC distribution for your reference. Thank you for watching.